Hi, I'm going to tell you a story about cities as ecosystem and Vega Scene, a lab for development of urban ecology. My take-home message is that the cities are ecosystems. We have this connected nature from our cities, and that was not a good idea. Because we are facing enormous challenges, a collapse of ecosystem caused by urbanization and abuse of resources. Urban development is a part of the problem, but also a part of the solution. And remember again, the cities are ecosystem. If we first acknowledge that the cities are ecosystems and that we are a part of this system, we can solve the biggest challenges of our time: environmental crisis, abuse of resources, and loss of biodiversity. So I have this project checklist. Urban development projects should be innovative, beautiful and meaningful. They should be inclusive and transparent, financially and socioeconomically profitable. But through optimizing the ecosystem service, the urban development project should be an answer to the biggest challenges of our time. Consequences of climate change should be met with strategies for climate change adaptation. Overconsuming of resources and greenhouse gas emissions should be met with strategies for reducing this kind of stuff. Loss of biodiversity should be met with strategies for improving the biodiversity. And now I'm going to tell you how we use this approach in a small project in the center of Oslo, who is called Vega Scene. This is a quite small project who was to be developed between the first urban ecology zoning plan in Norway. And it's also the goal to become the BREEAM Very Good. And then I called into what we in Norway called a dugnad. It's meaning a job which requires a significant amount of voluntary work for the greater good. So I called the best people I knew in the field. It was professors, lots of people with PhD and stuff. And so this project was a co-creation between landscape architects, engineers, suppliers, scientists, students, authorities, building owner and renter. So I was quite lucky to have this team. So I gave them some big challenges. The first was climate change adaptation. Can you create the first blue and green roof in Norway that handles a 20-year storm event? About the resources, can you create a lightweight soil mixture with a high degree of recycled materials? Number three, biodiversity. Can you imitate national important biodiversity? So this is a work in progress. So maybe I look a bit angry at this picture. But one of the researchers in the team said that, okay, this is never going to work. So I just gave them 2 hours to find a new solution, close the door, and 2 hours later, they find this solution for the roof. So this is more like the work in progress. The researchers work with different kind of soil mixture who was optimized for the vegetation and optimized for carbon capture and stuff. And this was distributed on Vega Scene's roof in the year after. So scientists collected seeds in the Oslofjord area, send them by mail to Hardanger. They also get some seeds from the University of Oslo here. And they was nursed by the best on perennials in Norway, Torun Jono in Hardanger, and then returned to Vega Scene's roof as 7,200 plants. So to the results. We created the first blue and green roof in Norway that can handle a 20-year storm event. And we created this lightweight soil mixture with a high degree of recycled materials. And we also developed this unique Oslo nature. This project had a very significant butterfly effect. You get a global recognition in the BREEAM system for innovation, the soil mixture, and they were nominated to the Norwegian Construction Award in 2019. The solution with the blue and green roof is actually sold on the open market now. And we also won the Oslo Architecture Award and received silver in the Scandinavian Green Roof Awards. And the scientists are working on the roof all the time, and they're working to check if the storm water management is functioning as planned, and people from the national authorities, they work with stormwater effect as well, and they're going to measure if this roof actually works as planned. And the municipality of Oslo say that they can save billions with this kind of solution. And as I mentioned earlier, this is also become a change in the construction industry and is now sold on the open market. We use this in all the projects from creating soil that capture carbon to new districts. We have several new laboratories for urban ecology going on right now. And this is the roof in 2019, the first year. And this is the roof this year. So, what if this roof remains just another gray surface? Thank you.